going on here, man? This is the deal. Hey. Tasting this one and get to the food. What's really kind of interesting is when you start tasting a serious wine, meaning $35 in a bottle up, when you taste that wine, you can't get a taste or a real sensation of it by having a quick sip like this. Mmm, that's good. There's a reason. All wines, when it gets serious, have three distinct waves of flavor. There's a foretaste, middle taste, and an aftertaste. The foretaste on a scale of one, let's talk about seconds.
Which one do you like?
1 second, two, three, four, five, six. When a wine comes in the mouth and approaches you, it's logging on. It's announcing itself in the mouth. Hi, I'm Cabernet Sauvignon. Okay? When you pick up the bottle and it says $35, that's a lot of money. You say, well, why are you $35? As the wine comes in the mouth and enters, this is what the French call the attack. The wine is announcing itself to you, hi, Cabernet. What you're looking for is to see, well, why are you expensive? Here's what happens. About 2 seconds into the flavor, then you have acid starts with this little push, the arrows of... The acid starts causing the flavors to evolve. Okay, so the initial flavor starts getting amplified thanks to the wine's acidity. But the saliva in your mouth is alkaline, which neutralizes the acid, so the wine evolves to a point and then it starts getting neutralized, it comes back down here, we call this finish. Persistance, still a persistance, same thing in French, but attack, evolution, finish, and you've got 6 seconds. So a $10 wine, you put it in your mouth, and it kind of goes, hi, goodbye. You know? The $35 bottle of wine comes in your mouth and says, hello. That's a $50 wine, but I gave it a little extra. But the point is, attack, evolution, finish. This is what makes up wine and wine tasting. And what's really fun is, when you serve someone wine, if they're only used to having $10 bottles, then you pick a $10 bottle, Cabernet, whatever it may be, and you pick a $35 bottle, and you compare them side by side, and they'll see that the $10 bottle kind of comes in, falls on its face, and the $35 bottle comes in, climbs like this, and tapers off like that. You know, it's an auditory decay. It's very, very important, but only if you have two wines side by side can you achieve it. So I'm hoping that as I try to tell you how to use the model, is that, you know, if you think about what you're going to do when you leave here, is you're always going to make sure that you've got a magic window, okay? That magic window is 30 minutes. I like to even think of it as 15. You've got to bang them with something really, really egregiously good then. Lose the dips, chips, nuts, and all that stuff. Just put it aside, because if it's out there, they're going to mow it down. They're going to eat it no matter where it's in sight. You know? So you do that. You're going to start with bubbles, because we learned that people feel special with that. You're going to serve two wines side by side in two glasses, and you're going to use nice glassware. Most people don't have a dozen crystal white and red glasses. These are called power tools. You need a dozen crystal white, a dozen crystal red, a dozen flutes. Yes, they're expensive. They could break. Here's the rules. Never dry them the same night. We call it drink, don't dry. you use them tonight, and you put them aside, and tomorrow you wash them. You'll lower the kill rate on them by 30%. But you need to have a decanter. You need to pour your wines in a decanter. If you're doing two wines, you have to have two decanters. And why? Well, you can decant the wine off of its sediment. You can let the wine breathe. The reason why you want a decanter is because when you're coming out of your kitchen with your red wine in a decanter, you're looking cool. And this is about drama. It's fun to look cool. It's fun to do things right. So you need these power tools. Because if you don't have these power tools, I'll state it pretty simply, you ain't in the game. You're not even on the field, okay? And 98% of urban America is not in the game. So I'm just saying, this is not rocket science. Go buy these things, have these things. you know, chill the red wines. If you really want to have great fun, you know, you buy yourself one of those under-the-counter wine refrigerators that come with all different flavors and all different prices, but they're digitally controlled. They have two different temperatures, so the wine is always at the right temperature. You know, the ideal temperature for red wine, I'd say 68 degrees. I keep my refrigerator at 64 because by the time it comes out, it's poured in the glass, it's just at the right temperature. Otherwise, you have to take your red wine and go put it in the refrigerator. We chill these red wines, and I want you to taste them now. We chill these red wines down to almost freezing temperature. They're now like 70 degrees. I mean, it's a war to try to get them at the right temperature. It's very hard to do for a big dinner. But anyway, these have been dialed in. I mean, they're nifty little toys like digital thermometers. You know, you put this thing to the glass, and it just says, you know, let's see what this one's got up to. 73.9 already. I mean, it's almost impossible. So what I want you to do now is I just want to get in the experience. We're going to have the food. Try these two wines. All I'm saying is this, you've got two different flavors. You've got one wine that's really easy to drink and ready to drink. It's called Syrah, okay? It's an Australian Syrah, it's on your left. On your right, you've got Marcus de Caceres. It's a Rioja, it's a grape called Tempranillo. It's got some grip, it's got some tannin. This wine may not taste good to you by itself first, but I want you to taste it before the food. But I'm telling you, you eat the steak, the chicken, or whatever you order tonight, all of these things will go with this wine. You eat that first and then sip the wine will not taste as aggressive because the food will dampen the blow thanks to the food and wine synergy. So anyway, the food's coming out now. I have a new phrase right now. You got one spin around this planet. Taste life now. That's what I want to leave you with tonight. Don't wait until someday it's going to get better. Look at this room, look at this audience, look at these people that are here. It doesn't get any better than this. It cannot get any better than this. So spoil yourselves. You're worth it.
Yes.
Thank you.